Hello, boys and girls. Hope everything is going well. I want to go ahead and show you the 5-minute check for today. There are no real problems, but just a few little housekeeping ideas here. This lesson, of course, you're going to see it if you're watching it right now. Saturday's homework will be posted again tonight only. And then, of course, you got some work on Saturday. Test on chapter 6, test number 3, will be on Monday. All right, let's go over part 2. This one deals with kites. Now let's take a look. Well, they really only give us one example. So if you look at example 4 on page 416, you have a kite. Now, one of the properties of the kite is you have 90-degree angles right there. The diagonals are perpendicular. So we'll make this one. We're looking for that, we're looking for this, and we're looking for this. And the book says 52, but we're going to make it 50 to make it easier. All right. Well, we already know angle 1 is 90 degrees because the definition of what a kite is, perpendicular diagonals. If this is 50, if you pull this triangle out right here, you have 90 degrees, you have 50 degrees, and this one is what you're looking for. We'll call this one X. So you know by the triangle sum theorem, they all add up to 180. So you add that up and you get 140 plus X is equal to 180. You subtract and you get X is equal to 40 degrees. Remember, it's got to add up to 180. Now, another thing too is, if you look here, these two angles are going to be the same. So angle 3 would be the same as this one. So angle 3 would be 50 degrees. That's basically it. These two angles are not the same. These two angles are not the same. These two would be the same. So these would be the same, those would be the same, but not these two. This one would look like it's smaller, and this one looks larger. Okay? But that's pretty much it. Now, there is a chart on page 416 that you should know, and it looks like this. We went over all the properties of a parallelogram, and we'll do it real quick. There are 5 of them. 3 of them start with opposite. Opposite sides are parallel. Opposite sides are congruent. This side is congruent to that side. The top and the bottom are congruent. Opposite angles are congruent. This angle is congruent to that one. And that angle, that obtuse angle, would be congruent to this one. Opposite angles. Diagonals. If you draw your diagonals, the diagonals bisect each other. So if you look at a parallelogram, the diagonals bisect each other. So if this diagonal is 4, this one is 4. If this one is 8, that one is 8. That means they cut each other in half. And consecutive angles add up to 180. This angle right here plus this upper angle would add up to 180. Again, you got parallel lines cut by a transversal. These are called same side interior. Those two would add up to 180. These two would add up to 180. These two would add up to 180. And those two would add up to 180. Those are called consecutive. Those are the properties of a parallelogram. And a rectangle, a rhombus, and a square are all parallelograms. So they all have 5 of those properties, all 5 of those properties. A rectangle, however, the diagonals are equal to each other. So this diagonal is equal to this diagonal. So diagonal 1 would be equal to diagonal 2. Diagonal 1 would be equal to diagonal 2. They're equal. On a rhombus, the diagonals are perpendicular to each other, kind of like the kite. these diagonals are perpendicular to each other. So you got 90 degrees, plus it bisects the angles. So if this angle is 30, this angle is 30. This angle is 30, that angle is 30. You could subtract, add up 90 and 30 and get 120, and you could subtract from 180 and you could get the upper angle, which is 60. So this would be 60, this would be 60, this would be 60, this would be 60. Those are the properties of a rhombus. A square is a rectangle. A square is a rhombus. A rhombus, however, is not a square, and a rectangle is not a square. So what I'm trying to say is a square has all of these properties. The diagonals are equal, the diagonals are perpendicular, it bisects the angles. All of the properties of a parallelogram is a square. It's kind of like the big one. We talked about a trapezoid yesterday, and the properties of a trapezoid, let me think here a second. We have one pair of parallel sides. So here the top is parallel to the bottom. Those are your bases. These are called your legs on the other side here. Let's see, one pair of parallel sides. Okay, well they already told us that. An isosceles trapezoid, however, has the legs equal to each other. So that would make this angle equal to that angle, and this upper angle would be the same as that upper angle. Remember, if it's got four sides, it's got to add up to 360 degrees. And then finally, a kite is the one that we just talked about. It has no pairs of parallel sides. This one right here, we said that the diagonals are perpendicular, much like the rhombus and the square. Okay, because the square has the same properties as the rhombus. And we know the upper angle here, this piece is going to be equal to that one, and this piece will be equal to that one. And let's see if there's anything else. I think that's pretty much it. All right, so try to memorize this chart, memorize those properties. Let's see if there's any of them that we want to do real quick. All right, take a look at example one, or problem number one, rather. Okay, I'm going to zoom in. I did in the book, but let me zoom in on this one. Okay, what are the measures of these sides? That's the best I can do. All right, so let's take a look. All right, we know that this one is 78 right here. We know that this is 90 degrees. All four of these are 90. So if you take 90 plus 78 and subtract it from 180, you have this one. And this one is the same as this one. I'm going to say it again. This triangle is worth 180. I subtract 90, I subtract 78, and I get this angle. Now, use your calculator on that. They give you some screwy number rather than something easy. But again, 180 minus 90 minus 78 gives you this one, and that one is the same as that one. Angle 1 up here, what you're going to do is, you know this is 90, you just found this one, so you subtract 90 minus whatever that one is, and you get that one. Alright, and I think that's pretty much it. I think they all kind of work the same way. Let's take one more. Take a look at number 9. You know, again, that angle 1 is 90. All four of those are 90. So take 90 plus 53, subtract it from 180, you get this one. These are not the same. These are the same. So if that's 53, angle 5 would be 53. To get angle 2, you would take 90 plus 38, subtract it from 180, and you get angle 2. And angle 2 should be the same as this one over here, by the way. Angle 3 would be 38. All right, that's pretty much it for today's lesson. Might take a look at one more. Let's see what's going on here. All right, they tell us it's a kite. We know that this angle here should be equal to this angle here. So you're going to set 3x plus 5 equal to this one. You're going to work it out and get x. Once you get x, let's see what else we can do to get y. I would take this y right here and put the y right here. and then I would add up this, plus whatever you get for this angle. Once you place this equal to this and get x, substitute x back into here, work this out, and you're going to get that angle. Add all three of these up and set it equal to 180. Again, this angle is going to be equal to that angle. All right, I'm going to pause the video here. I hope you have a good morning, and have a good day. Good luck on your test, number 3, on Monday. This has been another edition of Mr. Toops' Classroom.